Putting God first can be difficult. What can we learn from Adam and Eve, who refused to put God first in the most decisive moment of their lives? Adam and Eve had everything, a beautiful home, a meaningful work. They loved each other, and they had the best food in the world, literally. I mean, they experienced peace from sunrise to sunset. Not only the absence of trouble, but God's peace, shalom, the absolute harmony of everything. They understood the ultimate hierarchy of our planet. God is above all. He is in charge. As the creator, he is also the owner. Humans stand side by side, managing, ordering, and subduing the earth beneath them in that hierarchy, but they do not own it. As long as they lived under this reality, everything was perfect. But one day, Adam and Eve decided to rebel against this hierarchy and eat the fruit. By so doing, they were using the prerogatives of God, the owner. When you are just a manager, you cannot pretend that you're the owner and use the resources according to your discretion. Their experience tells us that God is God, and we are not. And the principle represented by that special tree teaches us important lessons. There are restrictions that were established by the owner, useful reminders of his authority. He has reserved an indicated day of the week, as well as a proportion of our income, tithes, and regular offerings for sacred use. They are holy, and like that fruit, are not to be touched. At first glance, to respect God's exclusives may seem a loss, but they are just reminders, not only of his authority and ownership, but also an invitation to trust in his loving ability to provide. But Adam and Eve put self first, disregarding God's exclusives with terrible consequences. They lost not only their shalom, but their very place in the garden. To tamper with some of God's exclusives, the Sabbath, tithe, or promise, leads to the loss of the notion of who he is. It expresses a desire to occupy a place that belongs to him. Adam and Eve left the garden that day, but hoped for the salvation God promised to bring. Adam and Eve refused to put God first. The consequences were terrible for them and the people around them. God's love compels us to put his kingdom first, while Adam and Eve's example is a warning for us today. As we return our tithe and promise, we are challenged to put God first.